Probability theory. Consider this definition of terms. The first one, we talk of event. If they say event, event simply means the outcome of an experiment. If you perform an experiment, the outcome we expect from it is what we call event. Another one is sample space. If they say that sample space is the collection of all the events or all the outcome of that experiment. If you have more than one outcome there, then the collection of all the outcomes is what we call sample space. We can now move to probability. If they say that probability simply means the measurement of the likelihood of occurrence of an event. That is, we want to measure if an event will occur or not. The percentage, the degree at which an event will occur. That is mean of this likelihood. That is what probability measures. Now, if E is an event, and N of S is the total number of events in an experiment, then we divide probability of an event, E, as number of events over total events in the experiment, which we can write as N of E over N of S. What this simply means is that if you have many events in an experiment, to find the probability, we know the probability of certain events, and we know the number of certain events we are looking for. Then over total number of all the events. For instance, let's assume that in a class there are 4 boys there and there are 8 girls. So in this case, the total experiment here is the total event here is 12. If they now ask me to find probability of event boys, if event boys, it will now be number of event, that is the number of boys there, over total number of events in the experiment. This total number of events in the experiment over 12, and that is 1/3. So that is what they mean by probability. You just need to know when we are in primary school, we are given something like this. They ask us, they will shade this area. They will now ask us to find the fraction of the shaded area. We know that this answer will be equal to 1/4 in primary school. So this is what we call a probability. That is the number of that shaded portion over the whole portion that are there, which is we have 4. So our answer is 1/4. So it's talking about probability. Now let's consider an example. Let's consider this example. We have the sample space of an experiment is given as this. Obtain the probabilities of the following. Now, whenever we are given an probability question, the first thing is we have to know the total event in a sample space. That is, we have to know how many events do you have here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we have 10 events there. So I can say that N of S is 10. That's the first thing. And the sample space is also important. But we have been given here. We have been given the sample. Some questions we require you to find the sample space. But here we have been given, and the total is 10. We can now move to our question. The first one says, obtain the probability of odd numbers. We only need to know probability of odd numbers. You write it like this. Let me write P of odd. P is representing, or let me put it like this. It's representing my probabilities. Now, I will look for all the odd numbers here. How many odd numbers you have? So the number of odd numbers will be, we all know what odd numbers means. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 odd numbers there. So our answer will now be 6/10. This is 3/5. That's probability of odd numbers. The second one is even numbers. So we only need to know how many even numbers we have there. And even numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4. That is 4/10. The third one is probability of perfect square. For perfect square, we need to know what perfect square means. Perfect squares are numbers that the square roots can be found. If you can find the square root of a number without remainder, then that type of number is said to be perfect square. And what are the perfect square? Perfect square are 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, and so on. So we only need to know how many perfect squares we have in this sample space. And those are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 perfect squares there. So one side is just 6 over that total, which is 10. And that is 3 over 5. And finally, probability of 1. So we only need to know how many 1 do we have here. We have only 3. So our answer is 3 over 10. So that's our final answer. We now consider some special experiment. The first one is experiment of coins. And for any experiment in probability, we need to know the sample space. I'll first start with 1 coin. For 1 coin, the only sample space we have will be head, tail. So there are 2 sample space, there are 2 events here, just head, tail, the face and the other side. We call it head and tail. That is for 1 coin. That is how to obtain event for one coin. For 2 coins, the events will be obtained using a table. This is how we are going to construct the table. If you want to construct it, since we are having 2 coins, put 1 coin here. And for 1 coin, the events we have are HT. I'll put 1 coin here. Put another coin here too. So that is another HT. Then you begin to merge it together. If you merge these two, this will be H and H. If you merge this one, it will be HT. If you match this, it will be TH. And if you match this and this, it will be TT. So the sample space of 2 coins will now be HH, HT, TH, and then TT. So we have 4 total events in these 2 coins. If you consider 3 coins, for 3 coins, since we have 3 coins, 3 coins will be put as 2 and 1 coin. You put 1 coin in this place. 1 coin is head and tail. We have obtained the one for 2 coins. The 2 coins will be head, tail, tail, head, tail, tail. That's how we normally generate it. If it is 4 coins, I'll put 2 coins here, 2 coins here. Now we are dealing with 3 coins. I'll put 2 coins here. The 2 coins that I generated here, I'll put 1 coin here, making 3. So I'll begin to merge it. This will be head, head, head. If you merge this one with this, it will be head, head, tail. This one with this will be head, tail, head. This one is head, tail, tail. While this one is tail, head, head, if you match this, the second one, if you match tail with this, it will be tail, head, tail. This one will be tail, tail, head. And finally, we have tail, tail, tail. In that case, sample space becomes this. I've written all this out again. So we have 8 events here. So we can continue like that to generate others. But I have to stop at this 3 coins. So generally, the total sample space, generally total event in the sample space is 2 raised to the power n. That's the formula. Where n is the number of coins. So that means if I have 3 coins, it will be 2 raised to the power 3, which is 8. 2 coins is 2 raised to the power 2, which is 4. So if I'm to generate for 4 coins, I will have gotten 2 raised to the power 4, which is 16 as our answer. Now let's now consider examples on this. Now we have a question there, example 2. A coin is tossed twice. What is the probability of getting a head, no tail, at least 1 head, at most 2 heads? what I said before, what important most in the probability question is how to obtain the sample space. But thank God we have obtained the sample space for two coins, because the question says a coin is tossed twice. It tossed twice here. That means that this will be our sample space for two coins. The one we generated here, so we only need to take it. Now, we can now move to the question. The first question says probability of getting a head. Let's put it there, a head. Probability of getting a head will just be, you look for event where we can see one head. Just a head means one head. Here we can see one head. I can see it here, and I can see it here. In that case, our answer will be 2 over, because I can see two events whereby you have one head there. So our answer is just 2 over the total, which is 4. Our answer is 1 over 2. For the second question means no tail. We look for events where we can see no tail at all. There's tail here, there's tail here, there's tail here. This is only where there's no tail. So I have just only one event there. So our answer is 1 over the total, which is 4. And third one says probability of at least one head. If they say at least one head, this thing simply means probability of S is greater than 1 or equal to 1. And that simply means that head is greater than or equal to 1. That is, we look for event where we can see one head and above. That is mean of at least. This thing means one head and above. That is, so we look for where we can see one head. We can see one head there. There you can see one head there. Now, they said and above. And above means we can also check for two heads. Then we can see two heads. So the total events we have are 1, 2, and this. So we have three events there. So our answer is 3 over 4. And the last one is at most 2 events. Probability of at most 2 heads. At most 2 heads simply means head is less than or equal to 2. So we look for all the events that are less than or equal to 2. First thing, we look for events that are 2 heads. Events that are 2 heads we have here. The one that is less than 2 is 1. We look for events that has 1 head. This is it. And another one is 0 head. This one. 0 head means no head. So in that case, I will consider this. So the whole event will be our answer. So that my answer is 4 over 4, which is 1. So that means probability of getting at most 2 heads will be equal to 1. Now let's consider another example. A coin is tossed twice. Find the probability that the outcome is this, this, and this. Now, since we are talking about thrice there, that means we are looking for a case of 3 coins. And this is the sample space. These are the outcomes which you have generated the other time. Now, let us now move to the question. The first question says probability of 2 tails. Probability of 2 tails means we look for events that has 2 tails alone. Event that has 2 tails. There is one here. There is one here. There is one here. So those are the events that have 2 tails. So I have just 3. Our answer is 3 over 8. Now, for B, this one says at most 2 tails. At most 2 tails simply means tail is less than or equal to 2, just like what we did the other time. And less than or equal to 2 simply means probability of 2 tails plus probability of 1 tail plus probability of no tail. That means less than, we have considered 2, we considered 1, and we consider 0. 0 means no tail. Now let's consider probability of 2 tails. Probability of 2 tails, we have done that there. It gives us 3 over 8. Plus probability of 1 tail. We look for where we can see one tail. Where we can see one tail will be 1, 2. This is another one, 3. So that 1, 2 is 3/8. Plus a bit of no tail. Where there's no tail at all, this is the only place that is no tail. So that one is 1/8. So our answer, if you add this together, it will give me 7/8. If you look at the third one, for a bit of at least one head. A bit of one head simply means, at least one head simply means head is greater than or equal to 1. And that will become one head plus probability of 2 heads plus probability of 3 heads. So probability of one head, we have found it here, is the same thing as probability of one tail. We get the same thing. So that one gives me 3/8. Probability of 2 heads, that is the same thing as 2 tails. It gives me 3/8 because they are mutually exclusive. Probability of 3 heads. Here is 3 heads. This is 3 head here. It's the same thing as no tail. It's only one. One event, that is 1/8. So that 1, 2 is 7/8. So that gives me probability of at least one head. And that's all. And the last one there is we want to find probability that the middle, the last is head. The last is head. We only need to look for where we have the last is head. We can see it here, 1. You can see it here, 2, 3, and 4. So what we have there is 4/8, and that is 1/2. So that solves the question. So we move to experiment of a die. Now, experiment of dice. For one die, the outcome is just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You know, a die is labeled 1 to 6. It has 6 faces. So the only outcome is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for one die. Now, but for two dice, you have it in two cases. If you want to consider two dice, you put one die here and another die. You can see I have labeled that one die as 1 to 6 and another die here 1 to 6. You only need to be merging the numbers together to get the sample space. And the whole of this will give me 36. For the first case, I'll just be merging it. This will be 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, like that. This one too, 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3. The second case is summation. That is addition of this thing. 1 + 1, 2. That is what we have here. We had 1 + 1. The second case is addition. You add it together. 1 + 1, 2. 1 + 2, 3, like that. 2 + 3, 5. Something like this. 5 + 5, 10. That's the second case. So, but the whole of the outcome here is 36. So, if the question is mentioning sum, then we use this. If it is otherwise, we use this one. Let's consider example. Now, let us consider another example. This example on event of a die. The question says a die is rolled twice. Find the probability that the sum of the outcome is all this. Now, since the question is talking about two dice here, rolling twice means two dice, and it's talking about sum, then we have to make use of this one. You have to make use of this table here. The question says that find the probability that the sum is 9. Then we come to this table. We look for how many 9 we have there. So the number of 9 we have there will be 1, 2, 3, 4. So, and the whole thing is 36. So our answer will be 4/36 because we have 9 in 4 places. So in that case, probability of 9 here will be 4/36. That is 1/9. The second one says probability of 7. So we look for how many 7 we have there. So the number of 7 we have there will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have 7 in 6 places, so the answer will be 6/36. That is 1/6, and the next one is perfect square. We look for how many perfect squares we have. The number of perfect squares are 1, 4, 9, 16, and so on. So the only perfect square we have in this table are 4 and 9. These ones are not there. You have to count this out. Then look for how many 4 and 9 that we have there. So we have 1, 2, 3. These two are not there. We have 1, 2, 3. And the another 9. 1, 2, 3, 4. So making 7. So our answer, the perfect square will now be equal to 7 over 36. So the next one is less than 6. Probability of less than 6. So we look for all the numbers that are less than 6 in this table. And the numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't forget that these ones are not there. The numbers that are less than 6. We have 5 is there. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is there. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So our answer is 10 over 36. That is 5 over 18. So the next one is greater than 8. We look for all the numbers that are greater than 8 to solve that one. Now let's consider another example. This is another example. A die is rolled twice. It's talking about two dice. Find the probability that the outcomes are the same. Both are even. Both are square. Both are perfect square. One is odd. One is perfect square. Like that. Since this one is not talking about sum, so we have to make use of the first case. We make use of this. This is what we are using. Now the first question says, they are the same. So we look for where the outcome are the same. And that is 1, 2, you can see they are the same. 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 outcomes that are the same there. So the answer is 6 over 36. So the answer is 6 over 36. The next one is you are looking for both are even. So we go to the table. Both are even. Look for where both of them are even. Here now, we know what even numbers mean. But this one is even, but this one is odd. We look for where both of them are even. So this is even 1. Both of them are even here too. 2. Here, both of them are even. 3. 4. 5. 6, 7, 8, 9. Those are the places where both of them are even. So our answer is 9 over 36. Here is 9 over 36. That is 1 over 4. The next one is both of them are perfect squares. So I have explained perfect squares for you. 1, 4, 9, 16, and so on. We look for where both of them are perfect square. These two, they are both perfect square. So this is 1. This is perfect square. All these numbers here are perfect square. This is 2. There will be none here. I can see here. This is another 1. This is another 1. So I have just 4 there. 1, 2, 3, 4. So those are the places where both of them are perfect squares. So our answer is 4 over 36. That is 1 over 9. Here it says 1 is odd. We look for where 1 is odd. We look for where 1 is odd. Here, all of them are odd here. Here, 1 is odd. So we have 1. Here, all the rest. Here, 2. There's another 1. 2. Here, there's another 1. 3. 4. 5. 6. 7, 8, 9. This is 10, 11 and 12. This is 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. In that case, we have 18 over 36. 18 over 36, that is 1 over 2. And finally, one of them is perfect square. So we look for everywhere that one of them is perfect square. So this is 1, 2. That is everywhere we have this number and this number. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. It again, where one of them is perfect square. This is 1, this is 2. We can't pick this 3 because both of them are perfect here. This is 4, this is 5. So in this place I have 5. In this place I have 1 and 2. I have 2 here. In this place too, I have 1 and I have 2. One of them is perfect square. But in this place, I should have more than that. This is 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is 4. This place too should be 4. We didn't count it very well. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. These two are not there. This is 1 and this is 2. I have 2 here. I will have 2 here too. So that will give me 16, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. 8 plus is 16. So our answer is 16 over 36. So that here we have 16 over 36. So that is that about case of die. So we'll now move to probability of container. Now, probability of with replacement and without replacement. We first talk of probability with replacement. This type of probability occurs when an object is picked randomly from a container and replacing it back. Now let's consider an example. An urn contains 5 red and 6 black balls. 2 balls are picked with replacement. They pick 2 black balls, 2 balls, they don't tell us. From this urn, they replace it by with replacement. Find the probability that the balls picked are red of the same color or different color. In order to solve this question, this type of question, the first thing is we need to find the probability of each color. And before that, total sample space is important. How many balls are there? The total balls are 5 and 6. That is 11 balls. Now, I'll first need to find probability of red. Let my R represent red. And that will be equal to probability of red, there will now be number of red over total. We have 5 red. Also, we need to know probability of black. Probability of black, there will be number of black over 11. That is 6 over 11. I can now move to my question. The question says, 2 balls are picked at random. What's probably that they are both red? That simply means that the first is red, the second is red. Because here they have told us that 2 balls are picked. What's probably that the balls are red? That is red, red. I only need to write out the formula for red. That is 5 over 11. You say times another 5 over 11. This is 25 over 121. Also, the second one, they said they are of the same color. Yeah, they don't tell us whether it is red, red, or because there are 2 colors that we have there, red, red, and black, black. We don't know whether both of them are red or both of them are black. But what we can say is that since they said they are of the same color, we can only say that it's either they pick red, red, or they pick black, black. So we now need to write out what is probability of red. The red in 2 places, this one, 5 over 11 times another 5 over 11 plus this all will be plus a bit of black black 6 over 11 plus 6 times 6 over 11. This is 25 over 121 plus 36 over 121, and this should give me 61 over 121. So that is the second solution. The third one says of different colors. So we look of different colors, we don't know. They just told us that the two colors are of different colors. A bit of different colors. They told us that the two colors are of different color. We don't know whether it is red that comes first or black that comes first. But we can just say that they either pick red before they pick black, or they pick black before they pick red. This has shown that they are of different colors. I will now need to write what's per bit of red. Per bit of red there is 5 over 11 times per bit of black there is 6 over 11 or means plus. Per bit of red there, black here is 6 over 11 times per bit of red is 5 over 11. So that here we are going to have 30 over 121 plus another 30 over 121. That should give me 60 over 121. So that solves the question. So it is very easy like that. The next one is without replacement. Let's take example. A basket contains 7 white balls and 5 green balls. 2 balls are picked at random from the basket without replacement. What is the probability that the balls picked are green, of the same color, of different colors? So this with replacement and without replacement, we normally do them in the same way, but have slightly too different. The first thing, without any solving, we need to know the total balls. And the total balls will be 7 and 5. 7 plus 5, that is 12. That will be the total balls. The first one says, the question says 2 balls. There are 2. Now, sometimes the question may say that 3 balls. 2 balls are picked. So that possibly that the balls are green. So that means we are having green. But the question says without replacement. And that simply means I will have green. Oh, what's the probability of green? Oh, sorry. We need to know probability of green. Probability of green has given me 5 over 12. Because we are giving 5, then over 12. The next one, probability of white. That one is 7 over 12. We need to first know this. Before any solving, I cannot come to probability of green. Probability of green, that is 5 over 12. You know, I have green in 2 places. That is 5 over 12. But if they say that without replacement, that means they did not replace it back. It will no more complete 5 over 12 again. The next one, it will now be 4 over 11. Because when they pick this first green, the remaining green will become 4. And the remaining balls inside the basket will be 11, because they are 12 before. They have picked one green. The remaining one will be 11. The new green will be 4. So that finally our answer is 20 over 11 times 12. That is 132. And we can simplify this further. Let's take another example. The second question. Probability of the same color. If they say of the same color, we don't know whether they are both green or they are both... we don't know whether it is green that they pick or it's white. They only told us that of the same color. So what we can only say is that it's either they pick green or they pick white. From that place, probability of first green is 5 over 12. Definitely the second green will be 4 over 11. Plus, probability of first white, that one has is 7 over 12. That is this one, probability of white, 7 over 12. So probability of second white, it will not more be 7, it will now become 6. the whole of this will now become 11 because they have taken one white away. So that our answer will be equal to 20 over 132 plus 42 over 132. Then my answer will be equal to 62 over 132. Then you can cut it to simplify further. The next one is probability of different colors. Probability of different colors, we don't know whether they pick green before white or they pick white before green. Now, we need to know what's probability of green. In the question, probability of green is 5 over 12, while probability of white is 7 over 12. Now, let's find probability of green. Probability of green is 5 over 12. But they have picked one green. Our white is still 7. They didn't pick it. But since they have picked one green here, the whole of this 12 is now 11 because it's not up to 12 balls again because they have picked this without replacement. Plus probability of white, that is 7 over 12, starting from the beginning. But since I have picked one white here, green is still 5 green. But this total 12 has been reduced by 1. That will be 11. So that our answer is equal to 35 over 132 plus this one too is 35 over 132. Finally, our answer is 70 over 132. So we can cut it to get our answer. Let's consider another example. Now, let's consider this. A bag contains all this. The question says three balls are picked at random without replacement. There are three now. Find the probability that the balls are blue. The first thing is I need to know the total. This is the total, 14. I need to know probability of white, probability of blue, and probability of green. Probability of white here is 4 over 14. For blue is 6 over 14. And for green is 4 over 14. Now, we want to find probability of blue. Since they say that there are three balls that are picked. So that will be blue, blue, blue. And that will be equal to the first blue has given me 6 over 14. They don't replace it, definitely it will remain 5 over 13. It will be reduced. Since they don't replace it again, the next one will be 4 over 12. So that my final answer will be equal to 120 over this. We can still cut. Something can still go there. I don't need to do that. Now, the second one says of the same color. But we don't know whether it is blue that they pick first. Is that we don't know which color they pick out of the three colors we have there. They only told us that of the same color. So in that case, we can say that it's either they pick white, 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 or they pick blue, 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 or they pick, these are the three possibility things we can have, or they pick green, green, green. We do it one after the other. We have, for white, the number of white are, the first one, the probability is 4 over 14. The next second one will have been 3 over 13. It will be reduced. This one is 2 over 12. Plus, we have known about blue before. 120 over 2104. And for green, 4 over 14. In fact, it will give me the same thing as white. That is 4 over 14, 3 over 13, 12, 2 over 12. So that here will be 4 times 3 is 12, times 2, 24. And if you add everything together, it should give me 1, 12 plus 24 is 48. 48 plus 120, 168 over 2104. Then we can divide it to get our final answer. Probability of different colors. Since they don't tell us, but we just know that the three balls will not be of the same color. It's either they pick white, blue, green in this order, or they pick white, green, blue, or they just pick green, white, blue, or they pick green, blue, white, or they pick blue, white, green, or they pick blue, green, white. We have six this thing there. As you have seen, all of them, they are the same thing. I can just say that my answer is 6 times probability of white, blue, green. And that will be equal to 6 times probability of white is 4 over 14. Probability of blue, that one is 6. But it will not more be 6 over 14, it will now be 6 over 13. Probability of green. The green that we have there is still 4. So that one is 4 over, it will not be over 13, it will be over 12 because the equation says it's not being replaced. So that my answer will be equal to 576 over 2104. Now the next question says the first two balls are of the same color. Since they say that the first two balls are of the same color, the first two balls, probability of the first two balls are of the same color. If they say that the first two balls are of the same color, we don't know the one they are talking about, but we can just suggest that it may be that the question is white. Since they are picking three, it may be that they pick white, or they pick white, blue, or they pick white, green. I'll do the same thing for blue. Or they pick blue, or they pick blue, white, or they pick blue, green, or they pick green, or they pick green, blue, or they pick green, white. The question just says the first two are of the same color. You observe that for all these ones, the first two are of the same colors. So we need to find this one by one. What is white? You need to find it and give me the final answer. So that has been left as an assignment and it must be noted. You take it as assignment and solve it. We meet in the next video. So for the continuation of our lecture.